Wow. First off, that was a close one. But you know what? That's what democracy is all about.
Wow. That's right. Yep. You know, the bar's real, real low in this country. When Glenn Thibault can win the Sudbury by-election, when the party he's running for is embroiled in 3 criminal investigations, has bankrupted the province, there's no money, jobs are being lost. I mean, wow. You're right. How on earth did you win? The helmets must be awfully tight in Sudbury for this to happen, or maybe they just don't watch the news. Nonetheless, on the very day we learned that the OPP think that Kathleen Wynne broke the laws by bribing another candidate, they win! There you go. Rebecca Thompson. I'd say my head exploded, but I'm not really all that surprised because nothing sticks to this government.
No, you know, his last comment, this is what democracy is all about.
No, it's not.
A defecting NDP to the Liberal Party under the cloud of a criminal investigation where the OPP comes out on election day.
Like the day.
The day.
The day.
5 o'clock, as most people probably head to the polls. With allegations that perhaps 2 of Kathleen Wynne's top aides have engaged in criminal wrongdoing.
And I suspect that the only reason that Wynne herself isn't named is because there's not a recording of that phone call, because she is alleged to have also made a phone call to Mr. Olivier.
Yeah, 2 top aides, Jerry Lougheed and Pat Cerbera, make calls to Andrea Olivier. Andrea Olivier happens to be on the elevator when Kathleen Wynne calls him, so he's unable to tape that call. He's, of course, quadriplegic, so he tapes calls in general because he can't write things down. And he doesn't happen to have that tape, so Kathleen Wynne personally may skirt by. However, 2 of her top aides right now are being named by the OPP in these court documents. This is an ITO that very well could lead to criminal wrongdoing, lead to criminal charges.
Yeah, I'd be shocked if that actually happens. We've got 2 other investigations that are moving at such a slow pace that I don't know if we'll ever see any results of it, but nonetheless, you know, the Liberals win, but really we all lose here. There's nothing in this because Sudbury had an opportunity to send a message that we don't accept this kind of behavior. I don't care if it's the Liberals doing this. I don't care if it's the Conservatives doing it. I don't care if it's the NDP doing it. It's wrong.
So let me
And that doesn't even have anything to do with the performance of the Liberals.
Let me just dissect the numbers for a second. Glenn Thibault, who of course has been representing this community since 2008, first as an MP, now he won as an MPP. In the last 2000 federal election, he actually beat the Liberals by 14,500 votes. He only narrowly just beat the NDP in this election. So there's obviously not the spread. So you know that people did go out to vote for the NDP, or even Andrew Olivier in this case. He just happened to squeeze by. The other thing is Andrew Olivier, as you just saw there, won by just over 3,000 votes. The big question is where those votes would have gone to had he not entered the race. Would those votes have gone to the NDP, allowing them to win, or would they have gone to Glenn Thibault? Well, I believe that those votes would have gone to the NDP because those are protest votes against the Liberals. Andrew Olivier was supposed to be the Liberal candidate, and if you couldn't vote for him, then you're going to vote if you couldn't vote for the Liberal, for Andrew Olivier as the Liberal, you're going to vote for him as the Independent.
Yeah, I'm just wondering though, because people will say, oh, this is the union. Once again, the union's going out to support the Liberals, but I'm not really sure what the unions think they're getting here with this party, because anything you vote for with the Liberal Party, any kind of perk, because you're going to get your raises, whatever, are going to be completely wiped out by this carbon pricing that she's bringing in.
So the unions were split. The carpenters unions, who have been longtime supporters of the Liberals, came out to support the Liberals yet again. But you also had the OFL. You had all of the typical unions who did support the NDP.
So the Sid Ryan crowd.
The Sid Ryan crowd, who did support the NDP in this by-election. They also supported the NDP in previous by-elections.
Yep.
And what happens in by-elections typically is that typically it's a protest vote against the governing party, the Liberals. In the past, for example, you'll you saw in Waterloo, you saw in London, you saw in Niagara, that, for example, the NDP managed to pull it off. Well, in this case, it didn't work. And I, you know, you can read into as to why. I do not believe that Kathleen Wynne won this by-election. I believe that Glenn Thibault won this by-election.
Because he's so well-known in the riding.
He's so well-known. He's been, you know, he used to head up the United Way. He was a very, he's a very gregarious, charming, well-known personality in Sudbury. He used to be a media personality in Sudbury. Whereas the NDP candidate was fairly unknown. Mm-hmm. So you have an electorate who, and by the way, the OPP did not come out with this investigation with the, with this shock, these shocking results.
Yeah, pretty shocking.
Until Election Day. Don't
no,
forget.
No, but it was also because we did some digging. You know, we put the request in for freedom of information. It's not like the OPP came out actively and said, look, here, they don't care if this comes out. They,
no.
Look, we know where their alliance lays within the Liberal Party.
There's also advanced polls. So 2 weeks prior to Election Day, there would have been people who went out to vote. And frankly, would they have voted for Glenn Thibault at the time, not knowing exactly what how this was going to fall out precisely for the Liberals?
You know, Kathleen Wynne, who smiled behind Mr. Thibault, you know, it's not often when a party leader who wins a by-election skips the scrums. That was her opportunity to say, thanks, Ontario, you really, truly believe. She wanted nothing to do with the scrums. She dashed out to avoid the cameras because she knows what the questioning was going to be by the media, was how on earth did you pull this off and what do you have to say about the allegations? Now, they say, their line of commenting yesterday when this new information came out by the OPP was, it's common for an investigator to make an assertion in the ITO in an order to obtain a warrant. It is no way confirmation that an offense has occurred. So they're standing behind this move. She has stood behind this move of what they did, of approaching Thibault and whatever was said in that call. Is this going to plague her moving forward? Because look, I just don't see Sudbury as being worth the risk. Why was she so desperate to play the cards in this election? I don't understand what was in it for her.
You know,
it wouldn't have changed anything.
It wouldn't have changed anything. It hasn't changed anything, except that Glenn Thibault is now as part of the caucus. They already had their majority. What did it change? The only thing I can think is that prior to the 2014 election, they were looking to Glenn Thibault to jump ship. It didn't happen. This was their opportunity because, frankly, the Liberals in Ontario have a huge ego.
Well, we know that Howard Hampton's jumped back in, so he'll run for the NDP. He's got big name recognition, so he very well could take this federally. Would this maybe be getting, I mean, was it necessary for Wynne to win this so she could set it up, hopefully to have Thibault start campaigning for Justin Trudeau? I mean, I don't understand the bigger picture here for her.
Well, you know, sometimes the bigger picture is just that that parties want to win back seats. You know, they'll do everything in their
at the risk
ability.
Of this.
And don't forget that Kathleen Wynne and Andrew Horvath have a terrible relationship between the two of them.
Sure.
So if this is an opportunity to skewer Andrew Horvath, if it's an opportunity to skewer Thomas Mulcair, then guess what? They're going to do
it. But her ego, essentially, may come back to bite her, because if this does result in criminal charges, and I actually don't think it looks too good for them, this is going to nag at her, and what it does is erodes once more, the trust in this party. It's not bad enough that there were two investigations, now there's a third. This is how this party operates. I'm not saying they're the only party that's been caught in this kind of thing.
So the one sentence that it was very glaring as part of this ITO, which is this court document by the OPP, was in it, the constable said, I believe this reference to the Premier's authority threatens the appearance of the government's integrity. And so even though the accusations are against these two aides, because you can't prove that Kathleen Wynne actually said anything. Mm-hmm. In fact, Andrew Olivier commented that she did not mention a job or an appointment herself on the telephone call. The Premier would have had the authority to authorize this.
Sure. Yeah, your aides can't do anything unless the boss gives them the directive. There is no question, if you listen to these recordings, and you're more than welcome to go online and listen to them, there's no question that an offer was made. There's just no question. It's all there. You don't have to say, well, it's, you know, it could go either way. It's pretty obvious, both of them.
Yeah, and you know, it's the side of politics that I would think that would have led the Sudbury electorate not to vote for the Liberals. That said, clearly they voted for the local candidate. Clearly they voted for Glenn Thibault, who happens to be somebody who is extremely well known in the community. But this is not going to bode well for the Ontario Liberals moving forward. A third criminal investigation plus an investigation by Elections Ontario. Elections Ontario could also find that they have acted criminally against the law when it comes to the Elections Ontario Act, which is, of course, different from the criminal code. So
just another day of business, Liberal style.
Yeah.
It just is. Sorry, but this government has not changed its stripes at all. It's just a new leaderhead, just the same way of doing business. I got to leave it there.